exercise 8.1. First question, the angles of quadrilateral are in the ratio 3:5:9:13. The ratios of the angles are given. Find all the angles of the quadrilateral. So let us take the quadrilateral ABCD. The ratios of the angles are given. We are asked to find the measures of the angles. So I write let angle A, ratio angle B, ratio angle C, ratio angle D is 3, ratio 5, ratio 9, ratio 13. Therefore, angle A becomes 3 times X, B is 5 times X, C is 9 times X, and D is 13 times X. Because the ratios are given, we have taken with a constant X. We know by angle sum property of a quadrilateral, sum of 4 angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. Therefore, replacing A by 3X, B by 5X, C by 9X, D by 13X, we get the total is equal to 360 degree. So, adding 30x is equal to what? Equal to 360. So, x is 360 upon 13, which is equal to 12. We got the value of x. So, if x is substituted in each and every place of the angles, we will get measure of each angle. Therefore, angle A is 3x. X value is 12. Therefore, what is measure of angle A? It is 36. B is 5 times X. 5 into 12. It is 16. Angle C is 9 times X. 9 into 12. 108. Angle D is 13 times X, which is 13 into 12, 156. Therefore, we got the measure of A, B, C and D as 36, 60, 108 and what? And 156. Second question is, if the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, then show that it is a rectangle. So let us write what is given and what is to be proved. Diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, that is given. Therefore, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram and its diagonals are equal. Which are the diagonals? AC and BD, they are equal. What is to be proved? We have to show the same parallelogram with the diagonals equal is a rectangle. So, to prove ABCD is a rectangle. So, we draw a parallelogram with diagonals equal. So by proving two triangles congruent, we are going to bring this result. So how to prove a parallelogram is a rectangle? In the same parallelogram, if we prove each angle is 90 degree, we can prove it is a rectangle. So we are given a parallelogram. So here if we prove angle A equal to angle B equal to angle C equal to angle D is 90 degree, then it is converted into what? Converted into a rectangle. Because these two are given, we are going to take triangles with AC as one side of the triangle and BD is another side of a second triangle. So we take these two triangles. ABC is a triangle, one side is there. Now I am going to choose another triangle in which BD is a side of the triangle. Hope you understood, right? AB and CD are equal because they are opposite sides of a parallelogram. We know by property of a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. BC and BC, common side. Same side. And AC and BD are given in the question equal. Therefore, by triple S, the triangles are congruent. I write in triangle ABC and triangle DCB, AB and DC are equal. The reason is opposite sides of a parallelogram. BC and BC are equal. The reason is common. AC and BD are equal, that is given in the question. Because we got three pairs of sides, we use the condition triple S. By triple S, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DCB. Okay. So there are three angles over here, three angles over here. If I compare A and D, this A is part of angle triangle rectangle ABCD, because we have taken only this. So this angle denotes only this part of angle A, therefore this cannot be compared. Similarly, C is also part of the angle, which is the entire angle present in this triangle. It is angle B. So angle B is equal to what? Angle B is equal to which angle? Angle C. Corresponding angles. When two triangles are congruent, corresponding angles are equal. But B and C are adjacent angles of a parallelogram. Therefore, what is the sum of angle B plus C? It is equal to 180 degree. If you take these two are adjacent angles. Because these two lines are parallel, this is a transversal. What is sum of angle B and C? It is equal to 180 degree. Interior angles are supplementary. Therefore, B and C are equal and their total is 180. Therefore, what is measure of each angle? It is 180 divided by 2, which is equal to 90. We know angle A and angle C are equal, opposite angles of a parallelogram. These two are equal. C we have found 90, therefore A is also 90. B and D are another pair of opposite angles of a parallelogram. B we have found 90, therefore D also becomes 90. Therefore ABCD is a parallelogram and we proved each angle is 90 degree. Therefore quadrilateral ABCD is a rectangle. Let us see the proof again. Let us read the question. If the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, then show that it is a rectangle. So we are given ABCD is a parallelogram with diagonals equal. We have to show the same parallelogram with diagonals equal is a rectangle. So we have taken two triangles in which the triangles AC and BD should be a side. The given condition should be used here. So these two are opposite sides of a parallelogram. This is the common side and this is given in the question equal. Therefore by triple S the triangles are congruent. When two triangles are congruent, the corresponding angles are equal. Therefore, angle B equal to angle C. This is the main step over here. When there are three pairs of sides, three pairs of angles, which pair we are taking here, that is more important. We cannot take any two pair. According to the given question, what is suitable, we have to think over. Accordingly, we should take here. But B and C are adjacent angles of a parallelogram, which becomes 180. The angles are equal, total is 180. Therefore, what is each measure? Each measure is 90. We got C as 90. Therefore, A also becomes 90. Opposite angles of a parallelogram. B we got 90. Therefore, D also becomes 90. Therefore, quadrilateral ABCD is a rectangle. Now, let us see what is midpoint theorem. The statement is the line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and is half of it. Statement is little vague, but if you understand the figure easily, you can understand the theorem. Okay. It is a triangle, so A, B, C I have taken as the triangle. We know a triangle is the union of three line segment, and we know every line segment has a unique midpoint. Therefore, I have taken M as the midpoint of AB and N midpoint of AC. So this MN, if you consider, this is the line segment joining midpoints of two sides of this triangle ABC. The theorem says that this particular line segment, that is which joins the midpoints of two sides of the triangle, this is parallel to the third side. What do you mean by third side? Midpoints are taken for these two sides. Therefore, this is called third side. So this MN is parallel to BC. And if you measure this MN, it will be half of BC. If this is 8, MN will be what? MN will be 4. If this is 10, MN will be 5. So this MN will be half of this BC. And these two are what kind of line segments? They are parallel to each other. In the same triangle, suppose if you take M as the midpoint of AB and here L as the midpoint of BC, this is the line segment joining midpoints of these two sides. Because the midpoints are taken for these two sides, for this line segment, this is called third side. So this ML is parallel to AC and this ML is equal to half of what? Half of AC. If L is the midpoint of BC and N is the midpoint of AC, this LN is parallel to what? Parallel to AB and its measure is half the measure of AB. So the theorem is, let us read the theorem again, the line segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and is half of it. Hope you understood the meaning of the theorem. So let us write what is given, what is to be proved. There is no proof for this. Let us understand what is given. So let us understand this theorem by writing simple statement. I write P is the midpoint of AB and Q is the midpoint of AC. So in triangle ABC, P is the midpoint of AB and Q is the midpoint of AC. Then this PQ is parallel to what? Parallel to BC and PQ is half of what? Half of BC. This is very important theorem, we should remember this. In case if you take this R as the midpoint of BC, we can conclude QR is parallel to AB and QR is half of AB. And if you take this PR, PR is parallel to AC and PR is half of AC. So enough if you write for any one result. So we have taken only for these two sides and we have written the result. Theorem 8.10 is the line drawn through the midpoint of one side of a triangle. Through the midpoint. So ABC is a triangle. I take P is the midpoint of side AB. Now a line is drawn through the midpoint of one side of the triangle and parallel to another side. I have taken this line parallel to what? Parallel to BC. If these two conditions are true, a line passing through midpoint of one side and drawn parallel to another side will bisect the third side. This is the third side. So if you extend the line, you will find this line intersects the midpoint of what? Midpoint of AC. So a line passing through midpoint of one side and drawn parallel to another side will pass through midpoint of the third side. Let us draw different figures. Suppose if Q is the midpoint of AB, right? This line is drawn parallel to or parallel to AB. So this line will intersect BC at its midpoint, say R. So a line passing through midpoint of AC and drawn parallel to AB will pass through midpoint of what? Midpoint of R. That is the meaning of bisects. The third position is in triangle ABC. R is the midpoint of BC and this line passing through R is drawn parallel to what? Parallel to AC. So if you extend the line, definitely it will pass through midpoint of what? Midpoint of AB. So theorem is very clear. The line drawn through the midpoint of one side of a triangle parallel to another side bisects the third side. Bisects means passing through the midpoint of the third side. This is taken, therefore AC is called the third side, will bisect the third side. So let us write the meaning of the theorem. I draw the figure again. I take P as the midpoint of AB. I take L as the line. So in triangle ABC, P is the midpoint of AB and L is drawn parallel to what? Parallel to BC. Then L bisects AC, RBC. Then L intersects AC at its midpoint, Q. In triangle ABC, L passes through the midpoint of AB, L is drawn parallel to BC. Under these two conditions, L will pass through the midpoint of AC.